Hello friends, this is Nisar, your host for YouTube channel Shout Loud. Today on the occasion of World Health Day, we are discussing about COVID vaccine and its importance. We will have a special FAQ session, which will be covered by my partner Sanjay Khan. Welcome Sanjay.
Hello everyone.
We are also welcoming our medical experts, Dr. Akif Ahmed Beg and Dr. Ejaz Abdul Rahman. Hello Dr. Akif, hello Dr. Ejaz.
Hello, everyone.
So before we start, let's have a quotation for the day. It's time to build a fairer, healthier world for everyone, everywhere. With this, I'm starting this session. So guys, tell me about vaccination. What is vaccination and what is important?
Okay. So see, vaccination has been there in our world since many years now. So what does vaccination mean actually? So vaccine is nothing but is actually a part of a virus or a bacteria. Like any infection, if you get infected from anything, the vaccine is actually a part of it. But whenever we inject that inside our human body, it will actually induce our immune system. Like it will ask our immune system to produce antibodies to it, but it will not cause infection in the person. So it basically gives you protection from the infection. So in case if you get that infection in future, our body already knows this type of infection, they already know it. So it will prevent them from causing severity of infection as well as prevent them from getting those infections. So that's what actually what vaccine is.
Thank you, Dr. Akif. So in current times, as we are dealing with COVID-19 since a year, right? So everyone has a question in their mind. What is COVID vaccination? What is the main purpose of it and its importance?
Okay, so see, till now, there has been 8.3 crores of COVID infections in our world. And around with that, there has been many deaths. There are lakhs and lakhs of deaths which has occurred because of COVID. So the only way to end this pandemic or only way to prevent these deaths is to get vaccinated. So vaccine doesn't mean it should always prevent you from infection. So even if it is able to prevent you from getting seriousness or from prevent is able to prevent you from serious infections or to prevent deaths, then also it has a big role. So that's how it becomes very, very important for everyone to take vaccine and to take the most effective vaccine as.
Thank you, Dr. Akif. This has raised a question in my mind. What are the available vaccines for COVID?
Okay, so in India, we have two vaccines available right now. One is Covaxin and other is Covishield. Covishield vaccine is actually a live vaccine. So it's actually, there is some other virus called adenovirus. So which has been genetically, by gene-wise, it has been modified such that it resembles to COVID. So it is then injected in our body. And whenever it is injected in our body responds by attacking on that by producing antibodies. So that's how our immune system gets to know that there is something called COVID and our body gets immunized to it. And there is another vaccine which is called Covaxin, which is actually a killed vaccine. It is not a live vaccine. It is a killed COVID vaccine, which is injected in the body. So again, whenever it is injected, our body will react to it by producing antibodies, but that antigen which is injected will not cause infections in our body. So both have been produced in India only. So one is produced by the Serum Institute, that is Covishield, and another is produced by the Bharat Biotech Hyderabad, which is Covaxin.
Thank you, Dr. Akif. I want to make a little easier for our viewers in choosing the vaccine, right? As you have mentioned, there are two vaccines available in the market in India, Covaxin and Covishield. So if I ask you, what is the best vaccine? What will be your answer and why?
Till now, whatever data we have till now. So recently, there has been a study which has been done in UK and US, which is regarding Covishield. Like it is a similar vaccine which is produced by the other companies in UK and US. So they have seen that they have taken around 30,000 population, 30,000 people they have taken, and they have studied the data and it has been seen that there is efficacy of around 63% to 78% with Covishield. So that means that, what does it mean? What do you mean by efficacy? Is that if 100 patients has received vaccine, around 63% to 78% will not get COVID after receiving the vaccine. But there is a chance of around 20% to 40% that patient may get infections, that patient may get COVID. So what then? There may be a doubt ki then why are we taking vaccine? So see, it has all this data, all these studies have also shown that there has been 100% reduction in severity of infection. So that means that if you take vaccine, you may still get COVID, like you, but it will be very mild to moderate, but you will not get it in severity to cause deaths. So that's why it becomes very, very important to take vaccine. And there has been data from Covaxin also recently, and now it has cleared the phase 3 trials also, which has shown that it has proven to be around 80% effective. So however, if the question is asked, which is the best vaccine, the answer is whatever vaccine is available, do take it. So whatever vaccine is available is the best vaccine you have in your hands. So we should take those vaccine only.
So as we have available vaccines in the market, so what is the procedure to take the vaccine? For a normal human being,
sir, vaccination has been available to for persons in India. So whoever is willing to get vaccinated, they should download an Android or iOS app from Covin app. This app should they should download and register by using their Aadhaar card and select a nearby vaccination facility center over there, and they can visit that particular center according to their appointment. Or else they can directly visit a vaccination center by taking along with them Aadhaar card, and they can get them registered over there at the vaccination center itself and get themselves vaccinated through that. So this is the most simplest way which is available for right now, is that both Covin app, downloading the Covin app, registering over there and visiting the vaccination facility, or else directly visiting the vaccination facility by taking the Aadhaar card along with you and getting yourself registered over there. In private hospitals also many vaccination facilities are available. There you can directly visit over there and provide your Aadhaar card details, register yourself and get vaccinated immediately. So this is the way we can get vaccination.
Thank you, Dr. Ezaz. As we have a different set of age groups, right? We have children, we have elder people, we have middle-aged people, right? So is vaccination available for all age groups, or is there any age specific?
Here I have 2 points. Firstly, one point mainly I concentrate is that vaccination trials which have been done, they have been done on the persons above the age group of 18 years. So this makes it clear that people below the age of 18 years, that is children below the age of 18 years, for now they are not eligible to get vaccinated, because no data is available regarding how that is going to affect this particular population, that is below 18 years of age group or children's. They are not for now allowed to get vaccinated by government of India. Along with this, even though 18 years above age group are eligible, in that group only healthcare workers and frontline warriors, they have been allowed to get vaccinated in the first phase. And now in the second phase, government is allowing to vaccinate to the general population. In this general population, we have reached to a point now that from April 1st, anybody who is above 45 years of age are eligible to get vaccinated. In the general population, anybody who is above the age of 45 years is eligible to get vaccinated right now. So below the age of 18 years of age group, no one is allowed to get vaccinated. And 45 years above age group, general population is right now allowed to get vaccinated. This is the point. And I'm going to suggest that children and below 18 years of age group, they are not eligible for vaccination right now, because we don't have any trial related data on those particular population group.
Thank you, Dr. Ezaz. So do we have any vaccination cost or is that free?
Yeah, Nisar. We're lucky enough to be in India, because in India, we have government facilities. Many government facilities are providing vaccination at the free of cost. Any person who is above, right now, any person who is above the age of 45 years are eligible to get vaccination in any center at free of cost from government side. And in private centers also, many vaccination centers are available. There also it is very, very affordable and very reasonable. That is about 250 rupees per person they are charging for vaccination in private centers. So whoever can afford, they can get it from the private centers. Or even if they are not affordable, they can visit the government centers and get vaccinated in any of the government facilities available over there. Just you need to take your Aadhaar card over there. And along with this, we are waiting for others to be included, other general population to be included in further forthcoming months and weeks. So then also they will be provided with in this protocol only. So free cost in government facilities and rupees 250 per person in the private facilities.
Thank you, Dr. Reddy. So tell me about the post-vaccination care. If a normal person is vaccinated, what care he needs to take up post that?
See, based on the two vaccines which have, Covaxin and Covishield, there has been reports of like fever and body ache, headache, which has been seen with Covishield a lot when compared to Covaxin. So it's generally it is a mild thing only. It will come for a couple of days and it will go away. So for those of us who are getting any of these side effects, it is recommended that it is better to take a paracetamol or a painkiller for them for a couple of days till the time their symptoms subside. There has been no report with Covaxin as such till now, but it has been noticed that after the second dose, there has been reports of mild headache and body pain. So if there is symptom, they can take a paracetamol, which is a simple painkiller. And drinking plenty of water is what is suggested. Other than that, no post-op care, like post-vaccine care is required.
Thank you, Dr. Akif, for the detailed answer. Okay, guys, so let's move to FAQ session, which will be done by my partner, Sanjay Khan. Sanjay, over to you.
Thank you so much, Nisar. And hello, Dr. Ijaz. Hello, Dr. Akif. I have a few of the questions. So my first question will be for Dr. Ijaz. So if I take vaccine or I got vaccinated, can I still get the COVID infection after getting vaccinated as well?
Yeah, yes, Sanjay, it is a very good question. Because even if you get vaccinated, we are prone to get infected because that isn't 100% efficacy is there for these particular vaccines. That is the one option. And even after getting vaccination of two doses, any vaccine, Covaxin or Covishield, we are prone to get infected. But here the catch is there that the severity of the infection which we get after vaccination is very, very less. It is mild to moderate moderate infection will be there. And we can deaths will be prevented as severity of disease won't be there. So for this purpose, the answer to the question that even after getting two doses of vaccinated, we are prone to get infected, but it should be mild to moderate infection only. So severity of the disease will be prevented due to vaccination and deaths can be prevented due to vaccination.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ijaz. That was so informative. My next question will be for Dr. Akif. So, Dr. Akif, I want to know, there are many of the patients, let's say there are some of the patients who are taking medicines for blood pressure. They're taking medicines on a regular basis. Or what are the medicines which we are allowed to take pre or post this vaccination procedure?
Okay, so based on the data which are available, all people are on some medications, chronic medications which they take, like for diabetes, blood pressure, thyroid, or maybe for heart diseases. So it is recommended that they need to continue all those medications as such. There is no need to stop any medications, except only for one group. There has been few reports that patients who are taking anticoagulants, like there are drugs names like warfarin, acetrome, apixaban, rivaroxaban, and dabigatran. There has been reports that because these are anticoagulants and it are blood thinners. So whenever we take injection, we take it in our muscles. So there is a chance that whenever we put an injection or a needle, there may be a bleeding risk in there. And there are reports of hematoma, that is blood collection in our muscle, which has been reported high with these anticoagulants. So it has been suggested that patients who are on these medications, is better to stop these medications for 1 or 2 days prior taking to vaccination, and they can resume it after vaccination. Other than that, all medicines can be taken, like diabetic medication should be continued, blood pressure, thyroid medication should be continued without any doubt. And also heart medicines like Ecosprin or atorvastatins, all this can be continued pre and post vaccination.
Thank you so much, Dr. Akif, for this information. So medicines which all the patients they are taking, they can continue those medicines pre and post, except few of them. Thank you so much for this information. So, Dr. Ijaz, my next question is for you. There are pregnant women or lactating women. So, can they take this vaccine?
Sanjay, this is a good question. Actually, for now, we don't have any data regarding trials conducted on the lactating women or pregnant women. So these vaccines which we have been using, Covaxin or Covishield, for those vaccines, we don't have right now, we don't have any data that how this vaccine will respond in this particular group in pregnant women and lactating women. We are also waiting for that particular data to come. So as we don't have any data related to the clinical trials on this particular group, as per the guidelines of Government of India, those persons who are pregnant and who are lactating are not allowed to get vaccinated for now.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ejaz. Thank you so much for this information. My next question is for Dr. Akif. Dr. Akif, I want to know what will be the contraindications after taking the vaccine? What are the contraindications that we'll be getting after the vaccination?
The only contraindications to taking vaccination is that if you are pregnant or lactating or breastfeeding, you shouldn't take a vaccine because no data is available for them. And also children who are less than 18 years of age, there is no data, so they shouldn't take vaccine. And only other contraindications which have been mentioned is that if anybody develops any allergic reaction to first dose of vaccine, they are not supposed to take the second dose of vaccine. So reaction should be severe. The reaction doesn't mean mild headache, fever or anything. Reaction is like if you're getting a severe skin rashes, if you're getting sudden giddiness, you'll get collapsed. So all those things are called severe reaction. So only if you're getting those reactions, then only you should not take vaccine. Other than that, if you have any other mild symptoms, you can take second dose of vaccine as well without any contraindications.
Thank you so much, Dr. Akif, for this information. Dr. Ejaz, I want to know, because I have heard about this, these vaccinations are getting gaps in between, like we are having first dose, then there is a gap of few days, and then we are taking the second dose of the vaccine. So what are the gaps of taking these vaccines, or is there any fixed days in between taking these two doses? Or can you just highlight these things?
So yeah, Sanjay, for Covaxin and Covishield, these two vaccines we have been giving in India. So in this, both the vaccines are given in a two-phase manner, first dose and second dose right now. So for Covaxin, the duration between the first dose and second dose should be 4 weeks. And Covishield, recently we have got a new update that between two doses, the gap should be 6 to 8 weeks. As per the Government of India new guidelines, previously it used to be 4 weeks. Now they have found that the efficacy of the vaccination have been very good when we give a duration between the first dose and second dose of 6 to 8 weeks. So for that purpose, due to trials and updated guidelines, now it is said that for Covaxin, 4 weeks duration between the two doses, and for Covishield, 6 to 8 weeks duration between the two doses. That would be the duration we need to follow.
Thank you so much for this clarification, Dr. Ejaz. So my next question is for Dr. Akif. Dr. Akif, I want to know, there are a few of the patients are having HIV patients, and there are cancer patients as well. So are these vaccines are feasible or appropriate for them as well? Can these patients can take vaccine?
These patients, they can take vaccines. There has been no contraindications for them, and there have been no reports of any severe reactions in them. But only problem is that as these are like HIV patients or cancer patients who are receiving chemotherapy or any other therapy for that, which reduces their immunity. So see, vaccination works basically based on the concept of immunity. Like if your immunity is strong, if you're injected with a vaccine, your body responds by producing an immune response. So if your immunity is low, so it may not be an adequate response. So it just decreases the efficacy of the vaccine as such. So it may not protect you well from COVID, but there is no like side reactions or no chances of severe reactions in HIV or immunocompromised patients.
Thank you so much, Dr. Akif, for this information. So Dr. Ejaz, I have one question for you. If someone is infected with COVID, so if someone is already got infected, so when that person can take the vaccine, is there any time period like we need to cure first and then take the vaccine, or can you just help me with that?
Yeah, it's a good question, Sanjay. So any person who has been infected with COVID, they should be after completion of the quarantine period, like 17 days of quarantine period, after recovering from the COVID infection, after completion of 17 days, they need to be wait for 4 to 6 weeks to get vaccinated. So this is mentioned in this way that after developing infection, they will develop the antibodies which will protect them from the reinfection. So these antibodies will help him after recovering from the infection. That is around about 17 days, these antibodies will be very much developed in him, and these will provide the immunity for him from the further infections. But as we go along, after completion of 1 month or 4 weeks, these antibodies start to decline. So at that point, 4 to 6 weeks would be a good point to get vaccinated so that we can develop the immunity against the infection.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ajaj. So Dr. Akif, my next question is, I have heard for different reports regarding the clotting issues after getting these vaccines, and there are a few of the heart attacks or heart strokes with this Covishield vaccine. So should I still take or go for this vaccination?
There has been a lot of rumors regarding these vaccines that there is reports of like heart attack or any other bleeding clotting tendencies, which has been reported, but it has not been proved anywhere. So it was just a rumors. It has been not been proved anywhere. Even WHO itself, the World Health Organization, which is a like a health authority of the world, itself has mentioned it clearly in their recent articles that Covishield or Covaxin, any vaccine, is not known to cause any clotting tendencies or anything like heart attack or stroke. There has been no proven evidence for that. And also they have established recently they have now set up a committee to evaluate on that. So maybe in a week they'll be giving a report also about that, if there is any, actually is it because only because of COVID, or is it because they already have that underlying risk factors which make them prone to get those clotting risks, like smoking, alcohol, if they are diabetic, blood pressure. So there have been other risk factors which have also been found. So see, if Covishield was found to have this clotting issue, it should have occurred in even in young population. But there has been no reports of this clotting issues in young population. It has been seen only in elderly or old people who already have many risk factors. So this is not till proven. So I don't think it should be an issue. And moreover, see, around 9 crores of Indian population has taken this vaccine, and there has been only a few reports of that. So others are doing quite well only. So we should take the positive side of this debt, and rather than believing in the rumors and other things.
Exactly, Dr. Akif. If we are going towards saving the lives, so we should avoid such kind of rumors. Thank you so much for this information. And Dr. Ajaj, this might sound a bit silly question to you, but still, this is one of the questions which everyone is having in their mind, and most of the people that are having in their mind. Like, if someone got vaccinated, so can they stop wearing the mask?
Yeah, it's a very common question, very common doubt everybody is having. As we know, even after getting 2 doses of vaccination, we are still at risk of developing the infection. So even though it might not be severe, it can be a mild to moderate infection, as the efficacy of the vaccination isn't 100%. So there is a chance that we can get infected after vaccination. 2 doses of vaccine also we can get infected. So when we get infected, we can be able to transmit to others also. So for that purpose, first purpose, we need to wear mask to prevent ourselves from getting infected after vaccination also. And also along with this, to prevent we can prevent infection to others by wearing a mask. So for this purpose, even after vaccination, we are prone to get infected, even though that is mild to moderate, we can be carriers. So for that purpose, wearing mask should be mandatory, and social distancing should be followed, and hand hygiene and hand sanitation should be compulsorily done even after getting 2 doses of vaccination also.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ajaj, for this clarification on this particular doubt. So Dr. Akif, my next question is, if I take vaccine, can I still be a spreader among the patients, or can I still spread the virus after the vaccination?
As we have already discussed, like even if you take both doses of vaccine, this protection is only like 60 to 80%. So 20% still chances is that you can get COVID. So it's not, and also it's not necessary that you will get symptoms all the time. There are 50 to 60% time you may not get symptoms also. So you can spread it to other. So other problem with many of the people is that they think that they are young itself and they may not get any severe infection. But they need to remember that they may not get any severe infection, but if they spread it to the elder people who are elderly, who are more than 65 plus or have any other medical problem, if they by chance infect them, so it will be a very severe or danger thing for them and it may lead to their deaths as well. So we need to remember that for them, and that's why we need to follow all this guidelines which I mentioned, like wearing a mask, hand sanitizer, and social distancing becomes very important.
Thank you so much, Dr. Akif. Dr. Ijaz, I just want to know that a vaccinated patient can donate blood, like after vaccination, can someone donate blood?
Yeah, it's a tricky question, Sanjay. For now, we don't have any data regarding that. So I can't comment on that particular thing. As I can say that even though we have seen COVID infected persons after recovering, they have been donating plasma. So, but as far as vaccination is concerned, vaccinated person should donate or not, we don't have any data for right now. We are waiting for further data to come. So then only we can comment on this.
Exactly, Dr. Ijaz. If we don't have any clarification, we should not go for that. Thank you so much for this information. And Dr. Akif, my last question will be like how long the vaccine will be effective if someone got vaccine. So what is the time period that vaccine can protect that patient?
Answer for this question is again, actually, I don't know. No, actually, I don't know. Nobody knows the answer for this. See, because this is a new infection, new virus about which we don't know anything. So as more time passes, we'll be getting to know more details about it. And now as they are giving vaccination also, now slowly there'll be studies going on and they'll be seeing how long the antibodies are staying inside the body. So after some time passes, after a few months or a few years passes, then only we'll be able to answer these questions, how long these vaccines will give protection.
So much, Dr. Akif, thank you so much, Dr. Ijaz. Those are pretty helpful informations and answers from you guys. And I'll just hand over to you, Nisar.
Thank you, Sanjay. Thank you for covering up. So, friends, let's proceed with our next section, which is general suggestion and tips. So, Dr. Akif, Dr. Ijaz, this is a time where you can, put forward your recommendations, tips, suggestions, which we might have not covered in our FAQs or in general queries. So, feel free to add.
Okay. So, for summarizing, I'll say, both these vaccines are effective around 60 to 80% of efficacy. So, which means that it will not prevent you from getting COVID, but it will, everybody should remember that if you take vaccine, it will give you 100% protection. Till now, whatever data we have, it will give 100% protection from getting a severe infection, so which will reduce death. So that becomes very, very important. Okay, so that's important. And another thing is that after taking vaccination also, everybody should follow social distancing, wearing mask, and they should do proper hand sanitization. So that becomes very important actually.
Say that as you have mentioned in the starting of this session, so WHO said this year's theme for World Health Day, this is April 7th today. So it mentions that it's time to build a fairer, healthier world for everyone and everywhere. So it emphasizes on the concept that everyone should be eligible to get a vaccine. So right now, many countries and many people are not at all getting vaccination right now, but we are fortunate enough to be in India. In India, we have two vaccines available, and that is being made available by the government of India, and that is also being provided free of cost in government facilities, and also at a very, very, very affordable price of rupees 250 per person in private facilities. So it is very, very much important for us and fortunate enough for us to get these facilities in our country. And so right now, I suggest everyone to get themselves vaccinated as far as right now 45 years and above persons are eligible for vaccination in general population, and in forthcoming months and weeks all other populations will be slowly included into that journal. So at that point, whenever you get your chance, try to get yourself vaccinated as far as possible, as fast as possible, so that we can prevent severe infection and we can also prevent the deaths due to COVID.
very nicely said. Thank you so much, Dr. Ezaz and Dr. Akif, for your valuable information and recommendation. I hope our viewers will take your advice and proceed for vaccination. With this, we are ending the session. And hello, friends. If you have any other questions, feel free to add to our comment box. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Shout Loud, to get more interesting and knowledgeable videos. Thank you so much.